Texas, Richard, and of course the club from Texas, actually from here in Tennessee, Memphis, is down in that region as well, and they are following it very closely, because should Memphis beat Louisville and should Purdue win, then it would be Purdue and Memphis. Ray McCallum is with us. He's more concerned about those Ball State Cardinals and Arizona State. We'll preview the first game that we're going to have for you in the tournament tomorrow at 3 o'clock. Ball State and Arizona State coming up next on this special edition of Sports Locker. Stay with us.
This Sports Locker Extra is sponsored by RCA.
Bonzi Wells, Ball State's first MAC freshman of the year since a very different looking Ray McCallum in 1980. Welcome back to our NCAA tournament preview special edition of Sports Locker from the beautiful banks of the raging Mississippi. This is just absolutely gorgeous, Ray.
This is super. A great evening, and what a special place in Memphis. You know, I was born right down in this area, so it's a great homecoming for me.
And really kind of a warm greeting for you from the local press because of that background. I've kind of grown up here before you moved to Muncie as a child.
Well, you're right, Mark. They've been very kind to us. Ball State has been down here before. I played down here 2 years when I was in college,
right,
at Ball State, so they kind of remembered us. We didn't defeat Memphis State, but we played them tough.
They were Memphis State when we were here, and now it's just Memphis.
I don't know what that means, but they're still good.
You know, the Ray McCallum that was playing basketball here looks a little different than the one that's coaching here tomorrow, because you were about, well, that hair made you about 3 or 4 inches taller that you had.
But that was in style then. I was with it.
Your team, we were talking a little earlier in our newscast at 5 and 6, kind of nervous when they came out for the shoot-around today, but then things came around, they got that basketball in their hands.
Well, you're right, and I was really surprised because we've been under pressure the last 3 ball games. We had to win them or our season was going to be over, and the guys stepped up and played well, but I think they were kind of overwhelmed coming into the Pyramid, which is a beautiful facility, and then just seeing the NCAA banner with Kentucky, Ball State, BYU. I mean, I think they finally realized that we're here. We've made it. And we're a little shell shocked.
And that might be a concern going into tomorrow's game against Arizona State because they are so strong. They've got Mario Bennett up front, tremendously quick guards. And I know that concerns you.
Well, they have to. And then with our young basketball team showing signs of being nervous today at practice. But I think once we get by the first 4 or 5 minutes and adjust to their quickness, because it's going to be a major adjustment. We haven't seen this kind of quickness all year long. And I'm even telling you this, we played Michigan State, and I think they have one of the finest backcourts in the country with Snow, mm-hmm, and Respert. But it's going to be a major adjustment for us tomorrow.
Hey, congratulations, but good luck.
Thank you.
We want to see you next week on the tournament special.
We're going for it.
All right, Ray McCallum, the head coach of the Ball State Cardinals. When we come back, Vince Welch, in the shadows of the mountains in beautiful Boise, Idaho. V.
Certainly is, Mark.
Last year, they land the plane, get on the bus, they have their practice equipment on, then they begin the shoot-around. Is that the plan again this year?
Yeah, in fact, many of the teams have already arrived, but Indiana not expected to be here until tomorrow. And as you said, they'll come in and get right to it. Not a lot of time to just hang out. It's a very business-like approach. And, of course, Bob Knight uses that approach all the time, regardless of whether it's regular season or the NCAA tournament. But they really step it up now, and we expect to see Indiana in here sometime tomorrow afternoon before the late afternoon practice session.
Has the consensus out west been that UCLA is the club that's going to advance to Seattle? Will they start in the west and stay there, Vince?
Well, I think they do, Mark. I think that's the thought, although I believe that everyone expects Indiana to give UCLA a very good test if the Hoosiers should happen to get past Missouri. And I think that maybe there's even some intimidation as far as Bob Knight is concerned, the great coach, and Indiana has pulled off some good tournament upsets in the past. And maybe UCLA is somewhat weary, but I would say the Bruins are definitely the overwhelming favorite out west, and actually to stay out west all the way to Seattle.
All right, Vince, thanks very much. We'll look forward to Indiana Friday as they play from Boise, Idaho. Here, Ball State and Arizona State tomorrow. You'll see that game here on Wish TV at 3 o'clock. We'll have updates for you on News 8 tomorrow night at 5 and 6 o'clock. We hope you enjoyed this special edition of our NCAA preview of Sports Locker. You'll see all the NCAA action here on Wish TV as we progress on the road to the battle in Seattle. I'm Wish TV Sports Director Mark Patrick for Vince Welch and Borges.
Capers looking low for Bennett, nothing doing there. Now Brewer goes over the top to Bennett, and they get a push on Gregory from behind, and Bennett had something to say to Gregory as he went by. Here's a look at Ball State from Muncie, Indiana. 19,000 students, maybe a little bigger than some people around the country would think. Beal looking low at Riley. Riley's battling down there for a spot.
I'm sure coming into this game, Bill Frieder has prepared his Sun Devil saying that, hey, look, at Arizona lost to Miami of Ohio, so let's not take Ball State lightly.
Steve Payne coming up with the rebound again. Ball State looking to run, and Gregory gets fouled by Capers as he looks to finish the break.
He sees Bill Frieder automatically making a substitution right here.
James Bacon is going to check in. And that's a big school, 42,626 at Arizona State. They're an at-large team, and they have a great record against teams in the tournament.
Bill Frieder obviously not too happy as far as the way his team got back on defense.
Gregory missing that first free throw. Bill Frieder will really work that sidelines. He'll work his players. He'll work the officials. And Bill, a perfect 5-0 in first round games. We asked him about that last night. He kind of nervously laughed. Gregory makes the second free throw. Gets Ball State on the board. 2-1 here early.
This is a good matchup. Randy Zachary on Capers. If Zachary's smart, he just needs to keep bumping him and make him work hard. Good
nice
steal.
Hustle by Wells. Wells in the open floor with the finish. Bonzi, his first two. And Ball State, their first lead. Good crowd has come down from Muncie. They're right up behind us, all dressed in red. Bonzi's been averaging 24 points a game over his last four games. Ray McCallum really excited about this kid. Thinks he's going to be a very, very good player.
You know, 4 games ago, one of those games was against Ohio where he had 40 points and 13 rebounds.
Gregory unable to get the handle down low as Arizona State nearly turns it over again. Let's watch Bonzi here as he finishes off.
Does a good job stepping in the passing lane, getting his hand on the ball, and he's just so strong, freshman of the year.
Capers gets it in. Veal's going to come up shooting, and Veal knocks down a three.
Here's that press by Arizona State.
Veal almost shot the three again, then he got stripped by Wells. Hit Bonzi up the middle, takes it right at Bennett. Bennett knocked it away out of bounds. It'll stay Ball State ball.
You like the way that Wells goes right at you trying to create a foul.
Quincy Brewer comes back in, and James Bacon sits down for Arizona State. Norris bluffs the three. Payne hasn't really touched the ball on the offensive end yet.
He's got Bennett on his backside there, and they don't get it to him.
Long three from the corner won't go. There's Payne on the offensive glass, and it's taken away down there. Here comes Capers with the head up. He finds Bennett ahead of the field, and Mario traveled with it as he tried to get it over the other side to Jeremy Veal. That is a tattoo, by the way, of Super Mario dunking a basketball, if you're worried.
He wasn't sure whether he was going to do it or not. They kind of tempted, you know, they were ragging on him to do it. He said, well, okay, I'll follow through. Go, go!
Stepping out of bounds, turnover against Ball State.
Well, they're lucky they don't call an offensive foul on Steve Payne that time. I think he's a little frustrated on the last possession down the floor where he got the ball knocked away from his hands, and he's got to make sure he stays out of foul trouble. Only fouled out of 2 games this year.
4 early turnovers. Beal gets it on top to Brewer. Riley, he'll shoot from nearly anywhere on the floor, comes up well short on that. Nice hustle play underneath, and it'll still be Arizona State ball.
Well, no question. The Cardinals really have to pick up their intensity as far as going after the basketball because the Sun Devils do not quit.
Quincy Brewer with the hustle play. Capers to inbound. Skips it out to Veal. Gregory doing a nice job bodying Mario Bennett off the spot. Brewer, little crossover move, trying to get it to Bennett. It comes back to Veal. Arizona State still plenty of time, 18 on the shot clock. They skip it to Riley, and he knocks down the three. And again, Arizona State comes with the pressure. Gregory the handle this time. Payne underneath, and he walked with it.
Arizona State, as far as their press is concerned, what they try and do is not only create turnovers within the half court, but also force the team that has the ball to come down and take four shots.
Working so far. Ball State with five turnovers in less than 4 minutes of play. Veal can't knock down the jumper. Rebound ripped off by Payne, and he clears himself some room, gets it ahead quickly to Norris. Norris will stop and go move. Tough shot by Norris comes up short. Tipped underneath, controlled by Arizona State. Here they come with the break. They've got numbers. Riley tries to cross over, gets away with the buck, and gets the bucket. 5 points for Ron Riley. And Arizona State out to the quick 7-point lead, 10-3.
Arizona State really outmatched right now. I should say the Cardinals of Ball State outmatched on the boards.
Here's Payne, misses the dunk, trying to finish strong, and Veal comes up with it.
Well, he's had two kind of like that. Off that rebound, when the ball was knocked away from him, he had a good rebound. All of a sudden, it was knocked away, and just kind of that, he almost lost sight of what he was doing.
Capers outside. Down the blocks, there goes Bennett. Won't stay for him. Follow won't go down. And we've got a reach-in foul. It's going to go on Gregory in the rebounding action, and that'll be the second on Amos.
The Sun Devils are just so active on defense. Look at, they stay after the boards. Here you're going to see Steve Payne missing the dunk.
If you could listen to what people really want,
defensive work by Burton.
And when you're not getting your shots off and things aren't flowing for you, it seems like everything doesn't flow for you then. The pass doesn't go right, bounce doesn't go your way. When you start making those shots, everything seems to go for you.
Payne can't get the hook shot to stay down. Ryan Reed has come into the game in the middle for Ball State. Amos Gregory sitting down with those two personal fouls. Payne now is covering Mario Bennett. Bennett looking for the ball. Capers has to kick it out. Brewer throws it up off the glass too hard. Payne battling for the rebound. And it'll be Sun Devil ball on the alternating possession.
Quincy Brewer does a good job penetrating the basket. At 6'5", he misses a shot but comes up with his own rebound.
Ball State's gone 3 minutes and 50 seconds now without scoring. Got a foul setting a screen. Quincy Brewer picks that one up. The Sun Devils on an 8-0 run. They own the glass and they own the game right now. 10-3.
Ball State really struggling with their shots within their offense, especially when they get it down, because Arizona State has come up with some good steals in the press.
Randy Zachary stepped through the double team and threw the ball away. Here's Mario Bennett. Bennett, the pass to Brewer. Brewer looked underneath it. Riley now kicks it back out to Capers. Capers beats his man. Tries to throw it underneath, rejected by Payne. But Payne, the last to touch it, Sun Devil ball.
I don't know. Capers was standing out of bounds. Just caught it in his hand.
Burt spins to the bucket. Yes, and a foul.
Ball State not getting ready for that out-of-bounds pass. They just weren't prepared when the official gave the ball.
Bonzi Wells picking up his first personal foul. Isaac Burton, known as the best defender on this Sun Devil team, completes the three-point play, and the Sun Devils continue to roll here. 13-3, foul called on Capers. Marcel picking up his first. Jeremy Veal is going to check in, and Bill Frieda is going to get Marcel Kuipers some rest, and there you see the run. 11-0, long lead pass, Wells on the down and out. And a reach-in foul is called. How about Nichols State up there early?
Arizona State just really has the quick hands. Riley getting called for the foul on the reach-in, but they come up with a lot of steals.
Miami of Ohio pulling off the upset, and Manhattan matching them here in Memphis. Here's Bennett, spins in the lane, and he gets the finger roll to go down.
Pretty move coming back the other way by Bennett. Ball State just really struggling. Not the great ball handlers that Pac-10 has played against, as far as like a Tyus Edney, Brevin Knight, Stanford.
Bonzi Wells gets his second bucket. He has four of Ball State's 5 points. They trail by 10. As the Sun Devils have jumped on him earlier here. The press, the story of this game so far. Burton now backs it out. Bennett trying to fight his way through, gets a spot on Reed. They kick it back to Burton, and that's a travel. Nice defensive play by Bonzi Wells jumping out there as Isaac Burton thought he had a shot, and then all of a sudden he just saw a lot of Bonzi Wells coming at him.
It's one of the few mistakes, though, that Arizona State has made. Really controlling the tempo of the game off their defense in that press, and also when they get in the half court, they're very patient on their passing.
We will see another coach tonight who uses defense to control tempo when Kentucky plays. Zachary coast to coast, and Riley comes down with the rebound. Burton waiting for Riley to catch up and get into play. Pass inside to Bennett. Bennett gets doubled immediately. Brewer underneath was open, and he gets two.
That's just it. Everything has been Mario Bennett, Mario Bennett. He's all conference first team in the Pac-10, but they really share the ball well.
Riley with a long distance three. And out of the pack comes Brewer with the basketball. Minutes to go, first half. Bennett, two more.
Well, Bennett gets the ball that deep, it's going to be tough to stop him.
Ball State takes a timeout. Largest lead of the game, 19-5.
The women.
And Ball State's going to have to find a better way to break the press after May Basket.
Sal Thompson has come into the game at the guard spot to join Zachary. They go inside to Gregory, outside to Thompson. Zachary swings it. Wells will take it. Comes up short. Rebound taken off the floor. All the rebounds so far going to the Sun Devils. 12-3 at this point.
And that's what's so hard with Ball State. You get one shot at the basket. And it's an open shot, but it's not a great shot.
Inside, Mario Bennett again. Got 8. 23-5. Ouch. Bonzi Wells tries to pick up the Ball State hopes.
Let him get inside.
Wells with 6 of Ball State's 7.
Ball State falling into that zone. They like to play a man-to-man. Burton getting called for travel, but Ball State would love to stay in a man-to-man. They just don't have the personnel to stay with Arizona State.
Watch Mario Bennett down low.
Look at the position he gets down on the baseline. He just turns, and there's no help by Ball State. He just goes right up.
Marcel Kuipers is going to come back in for the Sun Devils, and Ron Riley will sit down. Thompson looking to bring it up against the pressure. Zachary gets it down low, and foul from behind is going to go on Quincy Brewer. Now you can follow CBS Sports on cyberspace. Go interactive. Be an insider during the NCAA tournament. Match picks with the experts. Chat with the CBS crew. Check it out. It's the first from CBS on Prodigy and CBS on the World Wide Web. I know you're into computers, Danny. You'll be checking that out later on.
I know I got to start hanging with you a little bit more.
Steve Payne, third in the MAC in scoring at 17. You see the average up there. Rebounds, 9, field goal percentage. A very creditable, nearly 58% from the field. Ball State getting smoked to this point, 23-9. Good move in the baseline, and Payne comes away with a miss. Thompson looking to push, and Ball State trying to get some points in transition here. Zachary's going to take a three and knock it down. Something for the Ball State folks to cheer about. They go on a mini 7-0 run here, and are back within 11, 23-12. Capers, the floater, and it's tipped in by Bennett.
Oh, we talk about that dribble penetration, especially against that zone.
Norris gets it ahead. Gregory the dish, and Norris to finish. Nice play. First two from Marcus Norris in the game. Ball State coming alive a little bit here.
Well, this Cardinal team is a team that likes to run, too. They're not going to back down from you.
They desperately needed confidence. They've gotten a little here the last two or three trips. That's going to hurt. Isaac Burton buries one from the corner. Pushes the lead back up to 14, and a foul is going to be called on Jeremy Veal. His first.
Here you can see how they break the pass, and they get the ball over the wing, and Morris keeps coming down the middle and gets a pass back.
Amos Gregory with that good dish in the lane. Wells looking to inbound. Gets it to Norris. Wells comes to the ball now. Bullet pass inside. Good look. He found Thompson and got away from his man down low.
Bonzi Wells can do so many things at his size. He handles the ball. You can see the passing he does. Has a quick step on the baseline. Can shoot it from the outside.
12-point Sun Devil lead. As Capers, the exchange outside, gets it back. Bacon now gets it to Burton. Back to Capers. That's an offensive foul. Not much doubt about that call. Second on Marcel Capers. .909 left to play, 28-16, and Ball State a chance to get within 10 of Bill Frieda's club. Ron Riley has come back in the game for the Sun Devils. I know it's tough when you get a big lead to stay intense, Annie, but some of the zip has gone out of Arizona State a little bit.
Well, a lot of that has to do with their press. They just really don't have the intensity with the turnovers that they were creating earlier.
Wells pulls up for the jumper. Back rims it. Rebound taken down by Gregory in traffic, and he's going to be called for travel.
It's a good offensive rebound by Amos Gregory.
The front court for the Sun Devils, a 19-8 edge. Mario Bennett, better than half of that total, as he's 5 of 7 from the field. Front court really is dominating with that rebound number two.
No question. And Arizona State has knocked down already 3 3-pointers.
Bill Frieda talks it over with Isaac Burton as he brings it up the sideline. Veal on a wing. Riley's over there on the other wing. Bacon comes to a high post. Riley, another long three. That one goes down. 10 points for Ron Riley here. A junior who, if he continues playing the way he's playing, will someday be the all-time leading scorer at Arizona State. Norris unable to hit the jump shot. Bennett the rebound. Bennett calling for the ball. Bennett's going to shoot a three. He was calling for the ball all the way up the court.
Well, he's 5 of 24 coming into the game.
Mario Bennett looked up at Bill Frieda. Bill Frieda's going, get back. St. Louis out early on Minnesota. 13-point lead. Gregory hit down low. Foul's going to go on Riley.
Good passing by Ball State inside to get the ball to Gregory coming underneath, and you see Riley with the foul right there.
31-16, 15-point game as Amos Gregory steps to the free throw line. Norris will take a seat over on Ray McCallum's bench. Amos Gregory, 6'9", 260-pound senior. Played on the 1991 Junior College Championship team at Aquinas Junior College. Also spent some time at the University of Nebraska. And Gregory rolls in the second one. 31-17, Arizona State. We'll be back.
หรือปรับระบบต้องหาคนช่วยเสียเงินแต่ก็ไม่ดีขึ้นใช่ป่ะอย่างนี้ต้อง IBM
เฮ้ยงั้นต้องซื้อฮาร์ดแวร์เพิ่มสิไม่ใช่
IBM อ่ะก็มีบริการปรึกษาการจัดระบบเขาจะมาอยู่กับคุณจนงานเรียบร้อยเลยหุ้นผมขึ้นนะครับขายเลยครับ
Funny how the most inexpensive thing in this commercial is the car. It's one small car with big ideas. Get to know the all-new Geo Metro. Doesn't cost a lot, and it comes with a lot of great stuff. If you lock your keys inside, we'll help you get new ones. If you run out of gas, we'll help you get more. And if you get lost, we'll get you found. The all-new Geo Metro. With around-the-clock roadside assistance. Want to know more? Just call.
A lot of engines perform on race day at the Indianapolis 500. And no matter what machine they're powering, they're expected to put it all on the line all day long. And when it's a Briggs & Stratton engine, well into the night. Briggs & Stratton, the power in power equipment.
The forecast called for a calm, quiet meeting. But a tempest rages instead. It's often the case in today's international business climate, which is why we prepare to place high above it all with worldly comforts that refresh, restore, and renew. United Airlines, the calm before and after the storm. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly our friendly skies.
A camera, a microphone, two chairs. That's all he needs. The Late Late Show with Tom Snyder, the best conversation on TV tonight.
The Pyramid here in Memphis, Tennessee, the setting for first-round action in the Southeast region. Manhattan, an upset winner earlier today over Oklahoma, and now Bill Frieder and his Sun Devils have jumped out to a 31-17 lead on Ball State. Ball State coming back a little bit in this game, at least playing with a little more confidence. They looked like they were going to get whipped by 100 here about the first 8 minutes of this game.
Well, if they can continue to break the press, and if Arizona State lays off a little bit on the press. But foul trouble is definitely going to hurt Ball State.
Ryan Reed picks up that foul over the back of Mario Bennett.
He shaved his head specifically for the tournament.
Thank you, Ryan. Jeremy Veal will inbound, gets it to Brewer. Bacon's going to take a jumper. Can't get it down. Payne amongst three Sun Devils comes down with the rebound. Ball State down by 18 at one point in this game. Chance to creep a little closer here. Josh Smith into the game for the first time for Ball State. Steve Payne trying to get on track, takes the jumper, front rims, and Ryan couldn't control the rebound, and Veal comes away with it.
Payne is cold. 58% from the floor, and he's not getting the shots, especially when he missed that dunk. Didn't help.
Missed all three of his field goal attempts this afternoon. Burton outside. He front rims that three. Payne is doing a nice job on the glass, though. He's got six rebounds. Sal Thompson Reed trying to battle for a spot with Bacon. They get it into Reed. Reed spins along the baseline, rejected by Mario Bennett out of bounds.
Well, it looks like he's got the baseline, but Bennett comes out of nowhere. Bennett has broken the Pac-10 record for blocks. 107 broke Sean Rooks, and that was at 84.
Kind of destroyed that record, didn't he? Here's Bonzi Wells taking it into the lane. The pull-up won't go down. Burton there on the glass. Gets it up quick. Brewer able to control it. Spins, throws it up. He is throwing that up more for Mario Bennett than to go in the basket. Zachary now the other way. 6 minutes to go first half, and Ball State nearly turned it over again.
I think Ball State would like to keep attacking against this Sun Devil team, but they have such quick hands on the defensive end.
Reed trying to skip a pass. He skipped it too far over the head of Zachary out of bounds.
So Ryan Reed, the 6'9 freshman, just really makes a mistake in the sense of taking the dribble, first of all, and not going anywhere, and then just throwing the cross-court pass.
No one has scored for the last 2 minutes and 15 seconds. That's become a permanent graphic right there, 31-17.
Arizona State's also, their offense has kind of settled down a little bit in the sense of Capers is out of the game. He's got 3 personal fouls, and really, who knows how strong he is, but the thing is, when he was in there, he was making things happen.
Here's Burton, runs right into Zachary, no call, Veal, can't get the 3 to stay down, rebound taken by Riley.
Oh, great hustle.
There was good hustle by Zachary there. Here comes Wells on the break, he's been exciting on the break, good dish for Payne.
To make sure that dunk went down.
31-19, a 12-point game.
Good hands.
Rejected by Mario Bennett, but then able to follow it up for 2. 6 points now for Steve Payne as he starts to come alive. Cardinals down 12. Minutes 26 seconds left to go here first half. Arizona State in control. They're in the yellow. They jumped out to a big 18-point lead in this game. The Ball State Cardinals, though, have started to come back. Steve Payne picked up his first personal foul there. Amos Gregory comes back into the game. Ball State out of the MAC trying to come up with the second upset of the day for the Mid-American Conference. Miami of Ohio knocking off Arizona. And Ball State trying to turn the trick on Arizona State. Mario Bennett with 12 points steps to the line. Mario, one of 5 finalists for the Wooden Award this year. He got 15 finalists, excuse me. Mario would be happy to hear the news if it was down to 5. Riley up big for the rebound, but picked off the floor by Wells.
That's where the Sun Devils have just really controlled the tempo of this game, is on the boards.
Chance to get to within 10, though, with the 3. Norris swallowed up, takes the shot anyway. Rebound over the top, knocked out of bounds by Mario Bennett. It'll be Ball State ball. And James Bacon's going to come back into the game.
Ball State, when they've been able to get the ball down on their end of the floor and run their half-court game, they've done a pretty good job. What's hurt them as far as the boards are concerned, they can't get in and get a second, third shot.
See if Ball State can do something here with Mario Bennett going to the bench as we approach 4 minutes to go first half. 34-21. Arizona State by 13. Zachary looking to probe. Gregory turns and faces and makes the jump shot. First bucket for Amos Gregory, 34-23. Ball State creeps a little closer. See where Arizona State goes. Their first option almost always is Bennett inside. He's on the bench. Ron Riley, a long three, won't go. Rebound to Payne.
Well, Arizona State, they hit three three-pointers already, but also the fact that Ball State has dropped into the zone, they're not getting the inside looks as much, especially with Bennett out.
The Cardinals looking to get it under 10 as we approach 3 minutes to play here in the first half. Norris for three. 34-26, Ball State within eight. Ron Riley the other way won't go. Bacon has the rebound knocked away. It'll still be Arizona State ball.
Why didn't you catch him?
Randy Zachary came flying by. Ball State back in this game.
AT&T, this is Emily.
Emily, listen, my friend Doug told me something that shocked me.
Uh-huh.
He said that he saves on calls to anybody.
That's AT&T True Savings.
Anybody?
Anybody in the U.S.
Because I'm not making any circles.
No circles.
And I'm not ratting out my friend.
No circles. Just sign up, make $10 in calls a month, and we'll subtract 25% off your AT&T bill.
Ow!
It's true.
I want it.
AT&T True Savings. Save 25% to anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Your true voice.
There are lots of reasons to buy life insurance. Here are two great ones. I'm State Farm Agent Mike Foy. As the Goff family has grown, so have their life insurance needs. That's why we get together for family insurance checkups. I make sure to explain all the options, then they decide on the plan that's right for them. Ask your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. It's a great way to learn about life.
At BASF, we don't make the cooler. We make it cooler. We don't make the jeans. We make them bluer. We don't make the toys. We make them tougher. We don't make the water scooter. We make it lighter. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy. We make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
There's a place in the Big Apple where New Yorkers rush to be on the cutting edge. It's Jean-Louis David. A touch of Paris right in the middle of Manhattan. So if you're looking for a new you, drop in anytime at any of their locations. You don't need an appointment, just your Visa card. Because when it comes to your hair and Jean-Louis David, American Express just won't cut it. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
They steal babies to sell.
My baby!
And only one man can stand up to them.
We're going to do everything we can.
Chuck Norris has his hands full on Walker Saturday.
Well, hustle will get you back into a basketball game. Ball State's got a shot here.
Well, he was coming into our laps. And I tell you, Randy Zachary, who has started every game for the Ball State Cardinals, says, I'm coming back into this one, too.
He never missed a beat. He just kind of rolled over. He was gone before I knew he was here. 10-3 the run by Ball State. The key there, 6 minutes and 33 seconds. Arizona State only 3 points. Jalatel into the game for the first time for the Sun Devils. They continue to work their offense. Marcel Capers, you remember their point guard, on the bench with 3 personal fouls. And he was sick yesterday, did not come to practice. Down low, Bennett. We'd like to welcome our audience watching Nickel State and Virginia. That was Bonzi Wells of Ball State with that block down low. And Arizona State unable to get the shot off. Arizona State dominated this game early, led by 18, looked like they could win by 100. But then Ball State, with their fans behind them, have come back. They now trail by 8.
Well, they took the press off earlier, the Sun Devils, after they got that lead.
Amos Gregory threw it away after bringing it all the way up. Amos at 6'9 and 260 doing the point guard routine.
Also, you mentioned with Capers out of the game, Ball State had gone into zone. Now they're back into the man-to-man.
Mario Bennett outside, skips the pass. Delatel down low, gets the bucket, and gets fouled. Well, see now, Dave doesn't have to do any work tonight. He can just pop that one right off.
That's a great slide. Letterman isn't playing. That's number one.
Second foul called there on Steve Payne as Ray McCallum's club back into this game. Virginia with that four-point lead at the half. Happy that audience could join us here. Zalatell knocks down the free throw. ...37-26 as we approach halftime, and fouls called in the backcourt. Coming up on Pennzoil at the half, Pat O'Brien and Clark Kellogg will have live look-ins of other NCAA tournament games. Be sure and stay with us. Jeremy Veal picked up that foul, his second. Arizona State just one of their last eight as Bill Frieder tries to figure out an offensive combination that'll work. Marcus Norris with the free throw, his third point. He's a 67% free throw shooter. 10-point game, 37-27. There's the Super Mario dumping the basketball on the shoulder of Mario Bennett. Norris rolls in the second one. Ryan Reed's going to check back in, and Amos Gregory will go out. Isaac Burton continues at the point, and Marcel Capers stays on the bench.
Cardinals dropping back into the zone again.
Payne dropping down quickly every time the ball looked to get the ball into Bennett. Zalatell again, rejected down there. Bonzi Wells. Here comes Steve Payne on the break. He has it knocked away from behind. Veal dives for it. And it's going to be Ball State basketball.
That's really a good move by Ray McCallum to put his Cardinal team back into that zone. Sun Devils really struggled. They weren't hitting the outside shot, having a difficult time getting the ball into Mario Bennett.
37-28, 9-point game with a minute 22 to go in the first half. I think Ray McCallum gets to the locker room in single digits, he's got to be a happy guy.
Oh, no question about it.
Reed outside. Reed putting it on the floor. Needs some help. Zachary trying to force it down low, and it's picked off by the Sun Devils. Lead pass Zalatell up quickly, and he's fouled by Reed.
And that's a big question, too, as far as offensively for the Ball State Cardinals to take care of the basketball. They've got to get good passes in there.
That's a second foul on Ryan Reed. Couple of upsets already in the first day of action.
One spot, guys. Shoot two.
Wake Forest rolling. Joe Zalatell at the free throw line. Straight up to go here in the first half. A quick tournament summary, and Miami from the same conference as Ball State upsetting a Pac-10 team. Ball State trying to make it two in a row. Wells comes away with the miss. The lead stays at nine. Norris pull-up jumper is going to be well short, and it's going to come back to the Sun Devils. Hard to believe Norris missed that shot that badly.
Well, it seems, too, the last couple of possessions Ball State really hasn't been as patient on their offense to try and really work for a good shot.
Ray McCallum got the call there as Tom Lopes came in from half court and changed the call. Comes back to Ball State. Able to really get Payne involved offensively. Norris missing a three outside. Mario Bennett with the rebound. And the Sun Devils can just about get the last shot if they want. 37-28. They've got the ball and the lead. But the Sun Devils have played two very different halves here.
Well, no question. The Sun Devils were just a big drought. They were on 31 for the longest time.
Burton looking back at Bill Frieder. six on the shot. Burton, he's going to have to take it. He does.
And he makes it.
A big three out of Isaac Burton. 0.7 seconds still left on the clock.
That was the 30-second shot clock that went off.
And now they say that 0.7 second is gone, too. So Isaac Burton heads to the locker room. And the Sun Devils of Bill Frieder have got the lead. They haven't put on the scoreboard yet. Did he get off? Yeah, he did. That's the end of the first half. With the score, Arizona State 40, Ball State 28. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA basketball tournament will continue.
My hands were steady. My eyes were clear and bright. My walk had purpose. My steps were quick and light.
These are the men and women who make Chevy trucks.
I held firm to what I felt was right. Like a rock.
Considering the quality of our people, it's no wonder they build the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Oh, like a rock!
Burke's back with four famous suspects and one gruesome murder.
Too many crooks spoiled the stew.
That's Burke's Law. Returns Tuesday.
This is CBS.
When Chevy designed the S-Series, they didn't set out to make Ford Ranger seem obsolete. They just tried to build a truck that feels like a car. A truck that protects you with airbag and anti-lock brakes. A truck that Consumer's Digest would call a Best Buy. So you'd know you were getting a great deal for your dollar. When Chevy designed the S-Series, they didn't set out to make Ford Ranger obsolete. It just turned out that way. Test drive a 1995 Chevy S-Series at your local Chevy dealers today.
I'm sick and tired of this boat.
What's bugging you?
I'm sick of fishing. Look here. Harvey's fishing in the Caribbean.
Again? Where do you get the money?
I don't know.
You can receive tax-free money at age 65, plus guaranteed monthly income for the rest of your life with a retirement program from Farm Bureau Insurance.
Hey, guys! Look what I caught down in the Caribbean!
Hi, I'm from Jack's Pizza. Hope you're taking advantage of all those coupons we sent you. You didn't get our coupons? Okay, just get out the yellow pages and put the Jack's coupon... No yellow pages. All right. Try this. Just give us any pizza coupon and we'll give you our magnificent 16-inch pizza for $2 off the regular price. Well,
when you call Jack's Pizza, we'll be right over. We bring great taste to your door.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, an official NCAA corporate partner.
And hi, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien, along with Clark Kellogg. Welcome to Pennzoil at the Half. Arizona State leads 40-28, led by their front court.
Mario Bennett and Ron Riley have combined for 23 points, doing much work inside today.
All right, let's have a chance to take everybody up to Baltimore, where St. Louis and Minnesota are playing. St. Louis leads 41-27 right now. We'll get a little bonus coverage here. 17:05 left in the game. Here's Dick Stockton and Billy Beck.
And Kolander, who will come in for Thomas.
Second on the team.
And you know, why bring in a 6'9 guy if you don't have some kind of offensive set that's going to get him the ball down inside?
At the line, Jeff Harris.
Harris is going to have give up maybe 3-4 inches.
Jeff Harris, a 62% free throw shooter, makes good on the first. If Minnesota is going to be content in shooting from outside, might as well bring in a David Grimm and go with three guards.
Well, I mean, if you have an advantage as size, we saw in the first game a tremendous differential between what Wake Forest had over the A&T Aggies. But in this particular game, a different quality of athlete, but you still have to take advantage if you've got 3 or 4 inches per position inside.
16-point lead, so Minnesota got it down to 10, and it looks like St. Louis has had that 17, 16, 15-point bulge most of this game. Here is Orr firing away, and Townsend Orr, who is second on the team in three-point baskets, gets his first of the game and has 9. So Leonard and Orr, the two guards, each with 9 points to lead Minnesota.
Orr was the MVP of the Great Alaskan Shootout, where Minnesota probably played as three as good a games as against quality competition than anybody did in the country all year. Started their season off with a bang.
Here comes Minnesota, down by 13. Or behind to Jacobson. Jacobson misses a three. Offensive rebound by Walton. Walton taps it, and let's see who the foul is on. It's on
Harris. Yes,
Harris, number 42. And for Harris, it'll be his second foul.
All right, and so St. Louis trails by 50, or St. Louis leads by 15, 45 now to 30 in the second half there. We want to send everybody out to Dayton, where Nicholls State and Virginia are playing. Virginia leads 34-27. Here's Sean McDonough.
Virginia leads by 7. The lead was 4 at halftime. Nicholls State still has not scored here in the second half. Junior Burrow missed the first of 2. Virginia's 1 out of 3 from the line today. Big lift in the first half for Virginia from Norman Nolan, who had 8 points and 6 rebounds, did a nice job defensively. His career highs are 11 points and 7 rebounds, so he has a chance to have the biggest day of his career against Ricky Broussard's club. Ray Washington.
Good containment by Dean. Look at those hands. It's incredible. He catches passes, this guy.
Dean to the baseline. Burrow drops it in. And Nicholls State might want to consider a timeout as Virginia has opened up a double-digit lead, and Ricky Broussard calls timeout.
The dean of this gym is Harold.
And we'll be back to Dayton in a moment.
Think of someplace private, someplace quiet, someplace comfortable, someplace truly your own. Now, think of it moving at 80 feet per second. Introducing the all-new Monte Carlo, a very personal space designed from the inside out around you, the driver. The all-new 1995 Monte Carlo. Genuine Chevrolet.
The game of basketball requires hard work.
But you need to work even harder to succeed in life.
Life is no game.
Make smart decisions.
Don't use drugs.
If you or someone you know needs help or information concerning drug abuse, call this toll-free number, 1-800-662-HELP. This message provided by the NCAA.
Officiating's a very humiliating type thing. No matter how good you think you are or you get to be, you're only as good as your last call. And if you missed it, then you're not a very good official in a lot of people's minds. It's the only avocation that you have to start the first time out and be perfect and then improve from there on. When you got 10 people moving in a 94 by 50 rectangle at very rapid speeds, and they vary in sizes from, say, 6 foot to 7 foot and all different weights, you're going to have some contact. A lot of the big people are playing with their backs to the basket versus the smaller players are playing face to the basket, and they're moving towards you, and the big players are spinning and turn around and shooting jump shots and hook shots and that type of thing, and you have to move accordingly so you can do what we call see through the play. It is a very beautiful game, but it's a very physical game too.
This message provided by the NCAA.
Catch CBS in cyberspace with a road to the Final Four on Prodigy and the Internet. Talk to the experts. Go behind the scenes. Get online with CBS.
Welcome back to University of Dayton Arena, Dayton, Ohio. Sean McDonough, Bill Raftery, 18-20 remaining in the second half. Harold Dean has led the Virginia Cavaliers to a 10-point lead. Nicholls State, highly touted offensive team, 7 times this year they've scored 100 points or more in a game, but they've been held to 27 in more than a half. And Alexander blocked Kessel as he went up toward the rim.
Chris, with a great reaction. A little breakdown on the perimeter, and you've got your big guy supporting.
Nice screen by Alexander, then Dean lost the handle, and Kessel the push. And Dean came back to take it away, and then Kessel fouled him.
He is a relentless performer. Solid defensively.
Nicholls State foul number 20.
Now you think you got it easy when I get it up on the glass, and Alexander paying attention to detail, getting it out and a run the other way.
The foul on Kessel was his third.
Look at this, and you think of a fight, huh, Sean? 10 rounds. And they just keep punching Virginia. I mean, they're not going to knock you out. They just keep banging.
And they're landing solid blows now. First points for Chris Alexander, who only averages 2.7 points per game. And Virginia is pulling away. And another steal. Nicholls State continues to be very careless with the ball. That really hurt them. They had 12 turnovers in the first half, and many of them like the turnovers we've seen in this half.
All right, and so Virginia, Clark Kellogg, putting it together finally.
Yeah, they went in the halftime locker room and got that Velcro out.
Sometimes
everything's glued together
sometimes
now.
Sometimes those halftime speeches work. So 39-27 is our score there. Up in Salt Lake City, Connecticut, dominating Tennessee Chattanooga, 49-35. I want to get everybody up to date on what's going to happen tonight. 7:30 Eastern Time, Pennsylvania and Alabama, Texas and Oregon, Mount St. Mary's and Kentucky. Rick Pitino was 2 years old when Jim Phelan began coaching, and Colgate in Kansas. Our tips, don't hold us to it, don't sue us. About 7:40, we hope to get there. Hope you're enjoying your day here on CBS. Thank you for joining us on Pennzoil at the Half. I'm Pat O'Brien for Clark Kellogg. Enjoy the second half after a word from your very own local station. Stay with us.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil, an official NCAA corporate partner.
Why do more Honda owners come back to Honda? Car after car after car. It could be state-of-the-art engine technology, or extraordinary handling, or maybe it's the feeling that Honda is one car maker that won't let you down.
This is CBS.
Some places serve just any fish, not Frisch's Big Boy. The baked cod is 100% cod from the icy cold North Atlantic. The colder the water, the better the fish. And Big Boy insists on serving only the loin cut, the premium part. You get Frisch's special recipe tartar sauce, a fresh baked roll, soup, salad, and fruit bar, and more, all for just $6.20. Dinner is better at Frisch's Big Boy because they start with better stuff.
And that's no fish story.
Look at this. Nightmare and some other
kind. Greg Williams' mom asks just one thing of him, to call her every day after school. To make it easy, she gave him an Ameritech calling card.
But he's doing like I said.
Two different scouting reports off that first half that Arizona State played as we look at the numbers, 44% shooting. Anything jump out at you there, Annie?
Well, the biggest thing is that percentage, because Arizona State has shot the ball 10 more times. Also, the rebounding. That's been, you can see the front court scoring, though, by Arizona State. A lot of those are three-pointers. Offensive rebounds, 11 for Arizona State. And the turnovers, a big key, not only points off of the turnovers, but the turnovers themselves.
And lots of folks in attendance here today in Memphis, including Isaiah Thomas, now in charge of basketball operations for the new Toronto franchise in the NBA. So Isaiah here taking in the action and checking out the players. Ray McCallum, Ball State Club. Played much better the final 10 minutes of that first half. The zone helped him a lot, as you pointed out, Ian.
Well, there's no question. Plus, Capers out of the game definitely helped. And he's going to start this second half. We'll see how far he goes. He's got three personal fouls. We talked about him being very weak because of the flu, and he was on an IV. Mario Bennett was a big plus for Arizona State.
All right, Bill Friedel, let's see if his club can come out with the same fire they did to begin the game. Ball State with the opening possession, Randy Zachary to call the shots. Amos Gregory starts the second half, has it high. Gregory, who likes to put it on the floor, goes right to the bucket and finishes this time.
Amos Gregory, who was recruited by Tennessee to play football as a tight end.
I can see why. He's a big kid. Ball State back to within 10 here as we begin the second half. Big three-point play at the end of the half gave Arizona State that ball. Did Brewer for an easy two.
good pass up high. I think what Arizona State does so well is they look for that man at the high post position. And what happens, you're so concerned about Mario Bennett covering him that you lose sight of what's going on at the free throw line.
Zachary, the floater won't go down. Rebound controlled underneath by the Sun Devils. Here they come. Brewer up the middle to Mario Bennett. And it's blocked out of bounds by Bonzi Wells.
Well, he got that ball so far out on the wing, he just kind of cupped it and said, uh-oh, I got a long ways to go here.
Wells, the freshman, has come up big for Ball State here.
We'll see how Ball State responds, too, Mike, especially with Arizona State hitting that three-pointer at the end of the half.
Ball loose underneath. Most of the loose balls seem to come to the Sun Devils, and that one does, too. Norris quickly the other way, can't finish. Veal tries to keep it alive. It's controlled by Marcus Norris. Over the top, Payne for two.
Good ball movement by the Cardinals.
Steve Payne has done a terrific job off the glass, but still unable to get on track offensively. He now has 8 points. It's a 12-point game. Riley pops out. Brewer looking over the top of Bennett. Come this way. Down to 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Capers calls the play. Takes his time. Bennett is going to have to let one fly. He doesn't know how much time. Now he does. Oh!
Did he now?
Mario telling Bill Frieda he was in control the whole time there.
He called that one, didn't he?
Norris trying to push it. Payne shut off on the baseline, doubled by Veal, skips it to Zachary. Zachary out to Norris. They'll reset. Into Payne. Payne, little jump, hook won't go. Gregory on the weak side. He can't finish. Payne tips it home.
That's where Ball State's going to stay back in this game, is these defensive boards. But what happens when they get their big guys hitting the boards, their transition defense is slow getting back.
Watch Mario Bennett here just get this one off.
He doesn't even look like he knows what's on the clock. And that has been what a lot of people said. Well, he looks like he just doesn't even care out there. And he's just so easy going, and a nice little stroke right there. His 6th 3-pointer of the year.
Bennett looking for a 17th point, and he gets it. Wells trying to keep it alive. It goes out of bounds off Bacon, I believe. It'll be Ball State basketball. Trailing 48-34. Ball State again got in a big hole to begin this game, down 18 points about 8 or 9 minutes into the game. And now Amos Gregory, not realizing he couldn't move on that inbound pass, turns it over as he runs the baseline.
Arizona State setting up their defense on that press.
The alley-oop, oh, nice play by Bennett just to get that. Gets it into Bacon, it's knocked out of bounds by Payne.
Great rotation by the Sun Devils as far as the passes, and I think Ball State just got a little lucky knocking that ball away, but look at Bennett going after a nice pass inside, and the ball's knocked away.
Arizona State very patient on the offensive end. You think of a team that presses like they do, that they're going to be helter-skelter, and they're far from it.
No question.
Riley, that's a big-time three. 13 for Ron Riley, and it's a 17-point Arizona State lead. They're starting the second half like they began the first. Wells coming through on the baseline, got himself fouled.
Bonzi Wells in that first half was only 3 of 8 from the floor. When he made things happen, they were exciting, but he just never got into the flow of the game.
Ron Riley picking up his 3rd personal foul. Wells to inbound. Here's Wells. He's going to take a 3. Gregory battles for the ball, comes down with it, lays it back up, partially blocked, and we're going to get a goaltend. Give the bucket to Amos Gregory. He now has 7. But Ball State needs some stops here. Down 17.
Big time stop, and also have to get running a little bit. I think when they, in that first half, things were flowing their way. They got the ball running. They were attacking it, the Sun Devils. The Sun Devils were kind of like standing around a little bit. The zone was a big help for them in the first half.
Big help, you're right. Burton back to Capers. Capers trying to penetrate. He's hit on the way by either Wells or Zachary. They give it to Bonzi Wells. That's two on Wells. Two team fouls on the Cardinal and one on the Sun Devils here in the second half. We've played just about 4 minutes.
That's where the Sun Devils offensively is so hard to guard. They're such a good outside shooting team. They take a lot of threes, but also they have the athletes to penetrate into the seams.
Riley, nice ball fake there, and then knocks down the jump shot.
Riley having a big game.
He sure is. The game's leading scorer now at 17. Ball State trying to push the other way, and the ball's going to come back to the Sun Devils. We've got a timeout. Not a good start in the second half here for Ball State.
And 3-point field goals, 7 of 14 for Arizona State.
Ball State back man-to-man now. Thompson's out there chasing Riley. Bennett gets double-teamed.
Well, the one reason you go back into a man-to-man, you want to try and create something defensive. You feel that you might be have a better chance of getting a steal. You're going one-on-one on a block out after a shot is taken. So you feel like you've got a better position, but there they don't block out.
Riley down there with the finish. Count the bucket. And he's going to get himself to the free throw line. Arizona State has now opened up their largest lead. No bucket?
No free throw.
No free throw. All right, thank you. Reed travels as he comes across half court.
Well, what's so hard, too, with Ball State, they've got some big guys, and they're just not great ball handlers. They don't feel very confident at all. And I think somebody's taking a nap.
Sun Devil fan. Convinced this one is his. 55-36. Long way to go, though. 15 minutes. Ball State made a good comeback after getting down 18 in the first half. They got it all the way back to 7. Mario Bennett. Oh, nice pass by Bennett. Bacon unable to handle it, though. He gets it back. Can't put it down. Bonzi Wells to rebound.
Arizona State doing a good job getting back on defense.
Bennett really has a lot of skill, doesn't he?
There's no question. I mean, his defensive positioning, and he's such a great shot blocker, they're going to call a foul right there, but Norris does a good job penetrating the basket. But Bennett, we've seen him underneath and how he is able to twist underneath in the position he gets. I mean, he doesn't have much room down there to maneuver, and he gets these little spin shots going. We've seen him hit the three-pointer.
Yep, nice pair of hands. Nice
tough
hands.
Rebounder, and maybe a flaw in his game is at the free throw line.
I love you, Frank. I love you.
We can work on that, though.
I love you, dog.
Well, you know, he's had a tough time at Arizona State, too. He sat out last year. He had ACL and the knee problems. He's had knee surgery. And this is really his first year back. And it's the first time he's having fun playing because he's been injured for so long at Arizona State.
Bacon over the top. Might have got away with one there. Tipped it and controlled it for the Sun Devils. Ray McCallum on the officials as they go by, thinking his team get manhandled over here. Bennett again outside, putting it on the floor, drives on Reed, tries to spin it up. Bonzi Wells the rebound.
And this is where Ball State got going. They kind of picked up the tempo in the first half, and they felt like things were starting to work. And I think that that's what they would like to do, is obviously pick up the tempo. Arizona State has done such a fine job in this whole game controlling things.
Well, Sal Thompson hits a three to make it a 15-point game. Under 14 to go. Bacon comes to the high post a lot. A lot of the Arizona plays start off the high post.
They're such good ball handlers, too. As a matter of fact, Burton was a point guard, and they switched him to the small forward.
Taking it down to 7 on the shot clock. Bennett, another behind-the-back pass. This one, Zachary tries to get it. I'm not sure that Randy should have tried for that one.
Not on that one.
No short of a hustle, though.
No question. And as far as his heart is concerned, too, because he feels that every time he can go after the ball, you've got a chance to score.
He must have known he touched it.
Well, he's gone under and over.
Two on the shot clock. This is Mario's time here.
Let's see if they run a play for him to shoot the three-pointer.
Comes in. Burton comes up shooting. And that'll be a shot clock violation. But it comes away to Ball State. And there's a steal by Burton.
Great heads-up play by Burton on the defensive end. Just kind of hung back there. He's their best defensive player.
Isaac now in double figures. The lead is back up to 18. Gregory kicks it back. Zachary's going to take the outside jumper. That won't go. Bennett kept it alive. Whoa. Let's take a look. Watch Burton here.
He steps right into the passing lane. And again, you talk about the big players for Ball State handling the ball and really have no sense of where the defense is at time.
Burton with the big finish. Ball State with the ball under their hoop. 57-39. They've made an adjustment, we are told, on the scoreboard, saying that that three was a two. And so Ball State with just 39, and that's where we stand at 57-39. Arizona State looking to open up a 20-point lead, and there it is. Quincy Brewer banks at home. We were talking yesterday, nobody banks at home anymore. And here's Quincy showing us up. Arizona State continues to aggressively trap on the press. Steve Payne gets free for two. And Ron Riley right back the other way, rejected by Amos Gregory. Riley gets it back, gives it to Bennett, and he gets whacked as he goes through the lane.
There's no question the officials want to let these guys play, but when you keep coming down that low and slapping at the ball, they've got to call one somewhere.
Bonzi Wells picks up that foul. The Arizona's front court just dominating here this afternoon. Mario Bennett with 17, looking to add to those totals. Manhattan awaits the winner of this game, having upset Oklahoma earlier today. Manhattan, a little school that could to this point.
No question, they've got some good athletes too. And talk about the perimeter players for Arizona State. Manhattan's got some guys that can stay right with them.
59-41 as we're about to go under 12 minutes here at the Pyramid in Memphis. First round action, the Southeast Regional. Second game of the day, Kentucky against Mount St. Mary's. Tulane and BYU still to come here tonight. Norris hits a three outside. Arizona State looking for the quick answer. Bonzi Wells with the rebound. Here comes Norris, same spot. Not the same result, though. Sal Thompson able to track it down. Front of his own bench. Norris, Gregory out there for a little screen, gives it back to Thompson. Thompson's going to take it. Rebound. Payne got a piece of it, but out of the pack comes Brewer.
And that's what, just what's so tough for the Cardinals. They just can't get an offensive rebound.
Veal knocks down a three. The second for Jeremy Veal, the freshman. Back to an 18-point game. Payne with Bennett right there. Oh, boy, Bennett. Bennett had a lot of ball there, I'll tell you. He's going to pick up the foul. Mario here gets a lot of ball.
They do a good job getting the ball inside to Payne. Payne trying to pump fake. And Mario Bennett's timing is so good.
He looks looks, he bent it down low, and he's defending. Some guys try to lay in the weeds. Mario looks like he wants to come out and just kind of envelop you, you know? I mean, he really wants to go after you defensively. Payne unable to put the free throw down. He's got 10 points and 10 rebounds on the afternoon. Trying to cut into this 18-point Sun Devil lead. The second of two. We're going to get a timeout. 10:47 to go in the game. The Sun Devils in control. Isaac Burton just taking his time as the Sun Devils continue to eat into the clock. They have it down to 15 now. Capers trying to spin an eight, looking for Bennett. Veal better put it up. Tried to, knocked out of bounds. And I think there should be 1 second on the shot clock.
You know what's interesting, too, though? Arizona State offensively, I don't think, has done as good a job in the half-court game. I mean, for Ball State, and they're a very good team, I'm not taking anything away from them, but as far as the athletes, maybe to stay with Arizona State, and look at how many times they have come down to the shot clock. Yep.
They're going to put 1 second back on the clock. Where's Mario? Veal, the catch. That is a shot clock violation. Didn't get any iron. And so Ball State will get it back. Trailing 62-45. We are halfway through the second half. Arizona State with only one turnover here in the second half. You can protect the lead if you do that.
Well, they come up with the steals, too, especially against that pressure full-court press.
Gregory found a way.
Nice move.
Nine for Big Amos. 15-point game. And I think Gregory just got himself a foul up the other end. Amos didn't think so. That's a 14th foul on Gregory. Let's see if we can see it.
Well, not much.
No.
Not much at all. Usually the officials let those go.
Capers looking to get it in. Just barely does to Veal. No, he really doesn't. Sal Thompson aggressively on Veal. Watch him.
Good hustle by Thompson. He gets a hand on it, and then they're struggling for it right there, and it just falls out of bounds. Cardinals just can't get a break.
No, they can't.
I think they kind of made their own breaks early also, too, especially when Steve Payne missed that dunk, and they just missed some easy shots inside.
Bennett swallowed up, and that's going to be it for Gregory. Gregory reaching in, trying to slap the ball. Has picked up his fifth personal foul. That hurts Ray McCallum's club.
Well, the ball goes down low to Bennett, and he's so quick down low. Triple team, and again, not much contact.
Nope.
Amos Gregory had his hands up in the air.
10 points and three rebounds for Amos as he sits down. It'll bring Ryan Reed back into the game. Ball State loses about 50 pounds on that exchange. Here comes Ron Riley back in, and Jeremy Veal will sit down.
Also some experience as far as Amos Gregory being a senior and Ryan Reed a freshman. Good pass inside.
That was really nice, wasn't it? Great communication between Bennett and Capers.
And defensively, Ball State just not seeing where the ball is.
The lead at 17. It has been in the teens this entire half. Norris just kind of threw that one up on the way by. And Ball State gets the ball back.
The Cardinals have really had to work hard, too, Mike, as far as breaking that press. They are breaking it through the dribble, especially with their guards. And they have not looked to pass and to cut to the open spots and try and look to break the pass that way. There's a nice pass inside to Bennett. Wide open. And Ryan Reed, maybe not the player that is capable of staying with Amario Bennett.
Randy Zachary comes back in, and LaSalle Thompson sits down for Ball State. Under 9 minutes now to go in the game. Burton nearly picked off that pass. Ball State trying to get out of a 17-point hole. Zachary lost the dribble. Bonzi Wells down the baseline, and he draws a foul. Wells with a quick first step. Able to pick up the foul. Mario Bennett picked up that foul, his second. Mario leading the way with 19 points and 4 rebounds. And the Arizona State front court continues to dominate this game. And with Ron Riley shooting the threes, that's a combination that may just prove to be too tough for Ball State.
That's the first point in the second half for Bonzi Wells. Had 6 in that first half.
Points to lead. Arizona State's got it and the ball. And with some teams, you say, gee, do they go to a stall, if you want to call it that, too early? This is really offensively how Arizona State plays a lot of the time. They're very patient on the offensive end, even though they turn it over there for the second time. Wells banks it home, count it, and he'll get to the free throw line. This is just about the time in the first half that Ball State made some noise.
Exactly. Wells does a nice job avoiding the charge. He kind of comes to the side, and Ron Riley there not too happy about it, but Isaac Burton's going to get called for the foul.
Bennett comes away with the missed free throw. 13-point game. See if Arizona State tries to work the ball into Bennett. Zalatell back in. Comes to Bennett's side, makes the entry pass, starts to cut to the hoop, it's picked off. Here come the Cardinal. Norris, the dish underneath, Payne the dunk. And Ball State trying to make it interesting, back to within 11. And Bill Frieda wants a timeout. 7 minutes and 54 seconds left to go in the game, and Ray McCallum's club is making a little noise.
The women.
Seems like they'd like to get the ball inside of Mario Bennett.
Up to date on your game down there in Memphis. Arizona State leading Ball State 64-53, but a huge ending we're looking for up in Baltimore. St. Louis and Minnesota tied at 56, 10 seconds left. Here's Dick Stockton and Billy Packard.
Well, the play of the game right here, Orr firing. Great catch by Colander, and he puts it away, ties up the score, Dick. And you can see Charlie Spooner has put Turner in the game, so he's really got three guards out there. Who takes the last shot?
Tied at 56, and here is H. Waldman. Pulls up and off the rim. Rebound by Jacobson, and a foul or timeout called by Minnesota with 2.3 seconds remaining. So the Gophers will have the last chance. They've never led in this game.
And so we'll keep you up to date on that game as it unfolds. 2 seconds in there. Let's go back to Salt Lake right now.
The 11-point game, 6:40 to go. The Ball State faithful up behind where we're located, trying to make a little noise. Bennett immediately gets double-teamed as Payne comes to help Reed.
State Smith switching up their defenses.
down a three with six on the shot clock.
Riley playing with a chronic bad back.
Zachary out to Norris. Made one and missed one from that spot in about the last 2 minutes. Bonzi Wells comes up shooting and gets two. Wells having a nice game, unofficially with 16. Just working that clock with each possession. Bennett kicks it back out. Burton hit on the way by. The foul is going to be on Norris. 5 minutes, 41 seconds left to play. 69-57 Arizona State. As Jeremy Veal comes back in.
16.
Brewer got free. Nice move.
Coming back underneath with the reverse. You don't see a lot of players do that.
Arizona State has run some very effective inbounds plays this afternoon. Zachary able to get it over to Wells, throws it up for Payne. 14 now for Steve Payne, but kind of a quiet 14 and a nice feed from Bonzi Wells.
2 seconds on the clock out in Baltimore. St. Louis and Minnesota, 56-56. Minnesota with the ball. Here's Dick Stockton and Billy Packer.
To advance.
Tie score, 2.3 seconds remaining. There's the timeout story. Next foul by St. Louis will be 2 shots.
Dick, right now, if I'm Minnesota at 2.3, I try to get at the half court and call another timeout as opposed to trying the miraculous shot. They've got time to get at the half court. It'd probably be 0.3 seconds off. Still two would be plenty of time to get a half court set going.
Chad Kolander will inbound, and he's got Bashawn Leonard. Bashawn Leonard puts up the shot at the hole, and we go to overtime. So Leonard all the way with a three-point attempt misses, and we go into overtime with the score tied at 56.
And so we all go to overtime in Baltimore, and we'll keep you up to date on that as the day unfolds. Let's send you back to your game, where it's 71-59. 4:46 left. Here's Mike Gorman and Ann Meyer.
By Reed.
And a foul call. Ball State will get to the line. 4:39 left to go here in Memphis. And Ball State trying to make a late run. They have trailed the entire game by as many as 19. But with Norris going to the free throw line here, they can get it down to 10 with 4:39 to go. Ray McCallum trying to keep his kids up and in the game. Ball State has lost Amos Gregory, their big center, to fouls.
Yeah,
and Ball State just not getting the breaks. Every time they start doing something positive, it's just like something breaks them down.
8 points for Norris, and we are going to get a timeout. Get there for that matchup on Saturday afternoon. BYU, Tulane, Kentucky, and the Mount will be coming your way this evening from Memphis. The Sun Devil himself.
Ball State can get some breaks, pick up their defense a little bit, hit the boards, keep running the ball. I mean, they're in this game. Arizona State just has so much ability.
And they have been so effective all afternoon at taking the shot clock down into single digits. Bennett kicks it back out. Shot clock now at 10. Pass underneath, and Brewer gets fouled with 7 on the shot clock. That's got to be about the third or fourth time that that has happened. Arizona State gets it down to 7-6 and then gets fouled by Ball State.
And they are. They're being very patient within their offense, making the extra passes. They're going inside to Bennett. He gets double, triple teamed. He looks for the cutter to the basket. If the cutter is not there, then he kicks it back out. Then they pass it around. They come back to his side again, and they do exactly the same thing.
Quincy Brewer knocks down the free throw. Quincy not known for his free throw shooting. Just 34% on the season. Oh, Reed comes away with the miss.
There you go again, Mike.
No, I was usually when it's that way, you help them. You know, you say something like that and they bury them. Norris trying to find some offense. Credit to Arizona State. Steve Payne just can't get shots in this game, can he?
No, they have not been able to get on the ball, and give credit to Mario Bennett as far as guarding him one-on-one.
There's Payne finally getting it. The turnaround. Bennett got a piece of it, and it's picked off by Jeremy Veal. And Arizona State now will probably take the clock down to close to the three-minute mark. Up 12, 72-60. Bill Frieder over there on the sidelines signaling them to run through it again, whatever it is, and then a pass picked off there by Reed. Crossover move, Norris takes it strong, offensive foul is called on Marcus Norris, that'll be number four. Isaac Burton giving it up under the basket.
Norris bringing the ball back into the middle, and then you see the defense right there, Burton getting position. The offensive foul.
Joe Zalatell comes back in for Arizona State. Brewer will sit down. 3:06 to go in the game. Arizona State's got the ball and a 12-point lead. And looking like they are going to advance to the round of 32. Sun Devils just three turnovers in the second half.
In Baltimore Arena, St. Louis and Minnesota are in overtime. 2:06 remaining in overtime. St. Louis leads 60-58. Here's Dick Stockton and Billy Packer.
It's a 2-point St. Louis lead. Well, you really like that guy's talent, huh? He's got court sense. It's going to be a good one. But he's guarding a guy right now that has given Minnesota a lot of trouble today. That's a foul before the shot. And that will be the 10th team foul against Minnesota, and that'll be two shots for Highmark.
You see Jacobson, who had a nice game against Penn State, 14 points, 5 rebounds. Excellent scoop on the inside.
And he's just fouled out of the game on the other end. So Jacobson has left the game having scored 10 points. And he'll be replaced by Grimm, David Grimm, who has played very well when he's been in there today.
Grimm, who excellent jump shooter from the wings, something that may be valuable as they send Leonard through and out to the weak side where they may be able to rotate the ball either way. Grimm with a jump shot, or Leonard with a jump shot.
Highmark is 2-for-3 from the line. Not only did Jacobson score 10 points, but he had 10 rebounds as well. One out of two, and it's a 3-point affair now, 61-58. It's a one-possession game at this point with 1:40 on the clock.
And there you see the 2-3 matchup zone. See, here comes Grimm to the side. Taking a lot of time here.
Leonard and Orr in the backcourt. That's Grimm with the ball. 9 on the shot clock. Orr to Bashan Leonard. 3-pointer for Bashan Leonard, and it ties the game at 61.
Dick, with Grimm and Leonard in the game, so you can send one to one corner, one to the other. It's tough for that matchup zone to take care of them.
4 3-point baskets by Leonard, who has 18 points now for Minnesota.
Boy, and he has really got the handle on Clyde. Clyde can't even get the ball. Excellent defense. Here he comes off a double screen, but can't get there.
He has been shut out in this half. Clackett,
that's good.
And he finally breaks the drought with a big basket to give St. Louis the lead. There's a differential of about 10 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock now. Minnesota has never led. They have tied it a couple of times, including at the end of regulation. We're in overtime. And Walton misses Grimm on the other side, but a good rebound in there by Robinson, and the foul against Minnesota. Two shots at the other end.
It's amazing how Harris and Robinson have been continually on that foul line because they're doing such a great job on the defensive boards. Both of them are really tired, though. Look at Robinson crossing half court here. It's how having a hard time getting his body down the floor.
David Robinson, who has played a good deal in this second half with four personal fouls on his shoulder, 66% shooter from the line, and a timeout has been called.
All right, so with a timeout there, we're going to break away for a minute. We'll get you back to catch up on the ending of that game with St. Louis leading by two. Let's send you back to your game with about 26 ticks on the clock there. Virginia, Arizona State in command, and here's Mike Lehman.
We've got 22 seconds left to play, and the Sun Devils of Arizona State are on their way to the round of 32 as Bill Frieder now will clear his bench. Mario Bennett will take a seat and a look at our Chevrolet players of the game. Steve Payne from Ball State, 15 points and 10 rebounds, a double-double. And Ron Riley, 24 points and 8 rebounds. And Riley sat for about the last 4 or 5 minutes of this game. He was approaching his career high of 27, so a big day for number 32, Ron Riley. We understand that Ron, who's had some problems with back spasms, has had a little bit of a reoccurrence of that. And that's why he's been resting on the bench. Didn't show while he was on the floor, I'll tell you. 79-64, 15-point edge for the Sun Devils. Lopez Bacon is going to shoot it in the lane. He gets two. Sun Devils again playing full court defense. Rogers feeds it down. Steve Smith gets a dunk, and that is just about going to do it. A 15-point win this afternoon by the Sun Devils. Arizona State has played their way into the round of 32, 81-66, the final score. Let's go now to Pat O'Brien. Pat.
So that makes Arizona State alum Reggie Jackson happy and David Letterman unhappy at the moment. And let's send you back to Baltimore Arena, where the closing seconds of St. Louis, Minnesota are about to get underway. St. Louis leads by two. Minnesota just can't seem to get over that hump. We'll see if they do it. Dick Stockton.